Almost all the key geographies face a slowdown due to the ongoing trade frictions. And amidst a weak demand environment, steel prices declined by more than $100 per ton over the last year. While iron ore prices have come off their peaks and coking coal has softened a bit, the meaningful benefit of the same is yet to flow through, which has led to a drop in industry margins. In India, the steel prices were marred by demand weakness on the back of persistent liquidity issues, weak investment sentiment, and seasonal impact of heavy and prolonged monsoons. A slew of economic measures announced by the Indian government and the recent rate cuts by the RBI to address liquidity issues should yield results over the next few months. Moreover, with the end of the monsoon season and the onset of the festive season, we hope that there will be a pickup in the overall consumption and steel demand. We are reorganizing our footprint in India. The merger with Tata Steel BSL is already announced, and we are consolidating our wire business into Tata Steel Long Products, which will be our vehicle for long products. We are also folding multiple subsidiaries into four verticals: long products business, the downstream business, mining business, and the infrastructure and the utilities business. This will help us drive scale, synergies, and simplification.